Just Cheryl here. I've made it to my parking destination to go to my first solo, the longest I've ever gone, and the highest I've ever gone, Mount Romulus. I just have a few more things to do, like put on my hiking shoes, because I don't think these will be any good hiking. And then I have to pack a few things and my coolie towel. It's going to be so hot. I'm very not excited about the heat. So I have my coolie towel. As soon as I find a creek, I will be making that wet so it cools me down, put my hair up, and then I'll be starting the trail. So I will check back in on my trail. See you soon. Okay, so I had to walk 1.5 kilometers in to get to the trailhead and the information area. There's me right now, and I'm going towards this way. This is not the area I'm going, but showing in front of my mom, wondering why, how I would get out in case of emergency. There you go, mom. Okay, it was brutal with the weight, 30 pounds on my back, in the heat. I have my coolie towel, and this is the trail I'll be going down. Correction, it is not that way. That is a loop. This is the way to the little elbow trail. And this I will hike for 10 kilometers to the campsite. Here I go. Onward again. Okay, I was wrong again. I took the wrong way. I had to backtrack down there through here, the campsite a bit. Now I found where I'm supposed to go. I have to get down to the river and then back out. I just ended up where I began. I think I just did 3 kilometers that I didn't think I needed to do. It's this way, from here to here. Let's try this one and go in further and see if it's the right way. Oh my God. It's late. It's like 3 p.m. But at least it's now overcast and the sun is going down, or the clouds are covering it. So it's not so much heat for me. Okay. Let's see. I just talked to a very nice lady down there who backpacked solo to Mount Romulus campground. And she did it solo with her little Papillon dog. And I am going on the right way. So yeah, my first gut instinct to go around to that trail was right. And I just did 3.5 kilometers just for fun, I guess. Need it a little over 4 hours. It's like 20 to 8. And there's a lot of sweat. And I'm so glad I'm here. Oh my God. Getting up, it's 10 o'clock. I just slept as long as I could. It's overcast. My sleep was pretty good. I woke up a couple times to turn over, but then I fell asleep right away.
I'm so tired and I'm sore. I am going to just, I'm not sure if I can actually do the whole mountain because of how sore I am, but I'll try. I really like that it's overcast and might rain. I'm going to use a light pack. I'm not going to pack everything up. Everything's going to stay here. And I'm just going to eat some breakfast, get changed, and then I'll be ready to go. Trying to find the trail. Jeez, look how tired I am. This will be an interesting day. I guess that's everything right now. I talk later. So morning number one, waking up to a deer right beside my tent, eating breakfast with me. So close. Look how close they are, where it is. There's my tent. There's the deer. It's like really close. So adorable to see in the early morning before my hike. Okay, I had to cross like a little river. And now that yellow marking means to tell me I'm on the right trail. If you could look, if you can kind of see the view. All around. And I'm not really sure what mountain it is. So one of these ones. And feeling pretty good now that I ate. My backpack is so much lighter now. Now that I just have like my little mini pack that came with my big pack, the top part of it turns into like a day pack with still room for a water bladder. So that's what I'm on my back today. Kind of see much smaller. It doesn't feel like anything compared to yesterday. And now I'll just be continuing on this trail and be going up really soon. It shows like a kilometer, maybe a kilometer of this and then up. So we'll see. This will be interesting. I think I have one more river to cross. I'll be on my way. Or this is the trail here. And it goes around that river. I'll have to go check my map. Bye. I had to backtrack again, just a couple minutes. Looks like I was going the wrong way. Now I'm on this dry creek bath. Dry, whatever it's called. And now I think this is, there we go. I'm really close to start to go up. However, which way it's gonna get me to go. This was down there. Okay, it looks like this is the where I'm supposed to cross the river. I didn't bring my water shoes, so I have to do this in my bare feet. I'm gonna take off my shoes and socks and cross the river. It's the spot. Ah, shoes and socks are off. I'm gonna try to video it. It's freaking cold. Holy moly. It was so cold, I had to use both my hands for my poles. And it's deeper than I thought. It went up to my knees, so part of my capri pants got wet. But here's another sign I'm going the right way. This Canuckchuck. And then there's one over there. And there's a little flag right there. So this is it. Finally, I'm at the trailhead. And this will be the mountain up there. I don't know if it's the top of there or the top of there. I guess it's supposed to be this one. since it's the top.
Okay, I'm definitely headed on trail. This is what the little trail looks like. I think it's bringing me to the back of the mountain to climb. I'm assuming there's going to be switchbacks. Right now it's a steady climb up. It just smells beautiful. I had to wait a couple of minutes for my feet to dry from that creek. I don't want to start off a trail with wet feet. Log. And I won't be taking very many videos, as I do need to save my battery for today to make sure I'm on trail. And that takes up battery and data. Not much though, but definitely want to keep and save this battery. Okay, I'm about a kilometer in and I got a sign, the Chinukchuks. This is where I start going up. So I'm on the right trail. Okay, I think I'm done because all this up and it's a loose rock. My legs are tired, very tired. I'm stopping like every couple minutes. And then there's still another kilometer after that. After you go up here, you go down a bit and back up for a kilometer. And I just can't do that. I'm too tired. I'm like 11, 12, 1, 2, 3 hours in. Just, it feels like I've been here for 6. Okay, well, I am ready to get up. I'm tired. I did not have a good sleep. It took me forever to fall asleep. It's 10:20 now. I just finished a little movie that I downloaded. Now I have to pack and clear out the tent. Tear down the tent, and then pack the tent, eat, and then I'll be heading out. I figure I'll leave between noon and 2, depending on how I feel. So here I go. I guess I need to get dressed and brush this hair. I'm about 45 minutes in. This is the forestry road, whatever. This is one I'm on for 10 kilometers, but walking this way, just look at this beautiful sight. It's clear blue day. And look what I get to look at on my way. Back to my car. Just beautiful. The gate. Signs. Civilization. And when I get to the gate, I have another 1.5 kilometers to my car. Yay! I'm feeling pretty good. Not so many ups this time, mostly down. Or straight, so that helped a lot. Well, I'm at the gates. Time for me to put the phone away. Head back to the car. Whoop, whoop! I'm gonna get some Tim Hortons or McDonald's iced coffee. Oh, I need iced coffee. Yeah, iced coffee. And this is where beginning was. Made it. That was tough. The last couple kilometers at the end. Straight heat on a gravel road. So now, and my hair down, thank goodness.
Now I have to change my shoes, get these out. I'm so excited to get my feet all out and back into my normal slippers, as some people would call them. Head out and find the nearest McDonald's. Yeah, I'm excited. I'm excited to get home. Just chill out, lay on the couch, watch some TV. Maybe unpack tomorrow. And then I have tomorrow and then Thursday and back to work. Say bye-bye.
Hello, it's Cheryl's son doing the outro here. I hope you guys have an amazing rest of your day. Make sure to like and subscribe. And if you made it to the very end here, make sure to comment kitten. Yes.